just got a dream. It's an XVW and they're gonna be thrilling you. They get hardcore, blood covering the floor. They take it out of the ring, they the wrestling kings. When it comes to a show, be ready for the bows. Cause they ain't slow, sit right in the front row. Cause it gets crunk, no.
Queen Erica Dietz, and we are back finally.
Yes, back finally from celebrating our freedom, and tonight hopefully these guys have a lot to celebrate.
I hope so, because we're kicking this match, this whole night off, obviously, with the Tragedy Boys versus the Shamrock and Roll Express. This is a matchup I don't think I've seen in at all, honestly.
No, I always enjoy a little shakeup, and tonight for Enter the Shadow, we're definitely going to see a lot of different things going on we never thought we would.
A lot. All right, we're starting off with Gaston LaRue and Doug Charles right now.
I like me a little Shamrock and Roll Express, but I also like Tragedy Boys. It always sucks when you're caught in the middle.
It's always bad. Ooh. Oh, Gaston gloating.
Ah, that little shake and shimmy.
Was that a Shamrock shake and shimmy?
Oh, I like that. Yeah.
Yeah.
Shamrock shakes are amazing.
Ooh.
Gaston LaRue in a really different position. He might want to get that tag.
Good shoulder tackle from Doug Charles.
Ah, nice up and over, Gaston.
Oh. And Hennessy with the tag. Ooh. Big slap to the face. It knocked his ponytail out. I just noticed that.
Well, we get to see that luscious locks. Oh, he jumped. Yes, Don jumps right out.
Firing back. Finally getting a head over. Ooh.
Oh.
He loves smacking people in the face.
Yes, he does, don't he? But there's a kick out at one.
One, two.
One, two. I think it was like a 1.5, 1.75 situation.
Oh, there we go. There's that tag he needed.
Ooh. They dropped him right on his face.
Close another cover. Ooh, kick out right away.
Ooh. Oh, we love chops this time of year. Apparently knees to the face as well.
Oh, yeah. Those high knees are vicious. Doug Charles got a little something for both of them, but Gaston gets it right back.
Ooh, double stomp to the back of the back.
Man. There he goes. Percy going for that cover.
Kick out at two. And there's that tag. Ooh.
Oh, my
gosh.
Here we go. There's a cover.
Ooh, that was close.
Percy wasn't too happy with that.
No, not at all. There's that cover. Kick out at two again. They can't keep Doug Charles down.
There we go. There's another tag in. Gaston LaRue and those chops.
Cover again. Kick out at two again. Doug Charles fighting back. More chops. Oh, and then a poke in the eyes from Gaston LaRue.
Playing a little dirty, I see.
Ooh, kick to the gut. And a little, what was that?
There we go, going for it again.
Hennessy with a save.
I mean, he's not wrong. They have been cheating a lot tonight.
They always cheat. It's just who they are.
Gaston says he's the one that plays it by the book.
Doug Charles trying to reach for that tag. Ooh!
Oh, Gaston definitely needed that tag.
Doug Charles has been taking these boys on by himself for a majority of this match, but not anymore.
There we go. Got that tag in, and he was hot and ready.
Clotheslines for everyone.
Oh, and he's still not done.
Oh, body slam.
Oh, yeah. Here we go again.
Body slam again. Oh, that was beautiful. Oh. He folded him like a 4th of July lawn chair.
Oh, Percy goes in for the save.
These tragedy boys are relentless.
Oh, that's a good word for them. Nicer than what I was going to say.
Gaston took out Doug Charles on the apron. Ugh.
Hey, that's some teamwork right there, though.
Will it be enough? Ooh, not quite.
That was a shocker to a lot of people, including the tragedy boys.
What a tragedy. Splashes and forearms for everyone as well.
There's a lot of sharing going on tonight.
Sharing is caring. Oh!
Toss him, Percy. Ow, ow!
Leaves Gaston wide open. Oh!
Oh, no!
Oh, no.
Oh, there's a roll-up.
One, two, three. Wow.
Your winners of the match.
I was not expecting that.
Tragedy
Boys.
We won! We won the match! We won the match!
Welcome to motherfucking Detroit, that damn wonderful shit.
Out there, and he's trying to talk things through with Benjamin Chimera.
Trying to talk things through? He's trying to bribe him to leave.
I mean, you gotta be smart. You gotta have that game plan like he says he does.
I mean, the game plan says what? Don't lose?
Yeah. I mean, that's a good plan. Don't lose.
I don't think that game plan is gonna work for him tonight.
Well, I'm betting on Creed Costello because he is a part of the BBC.
Well, maybe Benjamin Chimera can knock some sense into the BBC now about what they've been, but that's just me. Ooh!
Wow, he might have knocked his soul out of Creed Costello there.
Just a little bit. Creed might have bit off more than he can chew. Creed finally fighting back, but it wasn't enough to knock Chimera down.
I mean, Chimera is a monster, that's for sure.
He's massive. He's like the Berlin Wall almost. But I think that fell, didn't it? I don't know.
Man, Johnny Sisko on the outside of the apron right now, making sure that Creed Costello sticks to the plan.
I think he's cosplaying as coach today.
Well, it says plan number two, stop losing. That's what I see on the clipboard. I mean, it's a good plan.
Oh, big knee to the gut. Chimera does not look happy.
I mean, Chimera never looks happy.
Not, he does not look impressed. That is the face of a man who is not impressed.
I'm not going to say this looks very good for Creed.
Ooh, chops in the corner. He whips him off into the other corner and takes him down.
Squeaked that one out there.
That was pretty.
Cisco has plan, I think it says D.
Win.
Yes, I think yes. Yes, there's a lot of plans.
I mean, if one fails, you have to have a backup plan.
Oh, and right now his backup plan is to get on the back of Chimera. I don't know if that's smart.
Probably not. It looks like he just wanted a piggyback ride from his dad or something. Ooh.
Oh, Creed going for it.
Oh, and a kick out at two.
Oh, nice try, though. You heard him. The ref is messing with their game plan.
I don't think it's just the ref messing with the game plan. I think it's also Chimera, but that's just an obvious choice.
Uh-oh.
Oh, no. He tries it again.
Oh, Chimera wasn't having it. He's a little angry now.
Chimera just sitting on top of Creed, giving him a bunch of punches.
I don't think Cisco's very happy with the ref.
And that's it.
Your winner of the match,
Benjamin Chimera, beat the dog crap out of him. Oh, no.
Cisco's not happy.
He better be careful with that leg. Oh, no.
You knew that.
Oh, no.
Okay. Chimera's always doing this crap.
Oh, my God.
Oh.
His whistle popped off.
Oh, great. Oh, the crowd is saying one more time. Oh, Cisco, I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry.
You know, for once, I think I'm actually sorry for him, too. Oh, my gosh.
Oh.
Being thrown like a rag doll.
Yeah.
from Cincinnati, Ohio. Weighing tonight at 165 pounds, here is picture perfect, DJ Jury.
This is kind of a big match for both of these fellas here.
Yeah, whoever wins this match gets an XVW contract. And by the look on both of these boys' faces, they are hungry.
Oh, yes. I've seen both of these men start out from the bottom and work their way up. I've watched them training for a really, really long time. So this is the fight that they want to win.
Regardless of who wins and gets that contract signing, they should both be super proud of everything that they've done to get to this point, because this is such a huge deal. Ooh!
DJ Fury making his way up.
He's ringing in that headlock, flips him over, and continues. Oh, it sounds like this crowd is mostly wanting TJ to go over. Ooh.
Oh, there he goes again.
Ooh, good shoulder tackle.
Of arm drags there.
Went for that drop kick, but Fury moves.
There you go.
One, two, kick out. He still pushes his drop kick out of the way. Hits the ropes. Ooh. And goes for a pin. Kicks out at two.
Fury's a slippery little guy.
Wow. And a standoff.
Wow.
This could be anybody's game. Oh, no.
Anybody's contract at this point.
Do you see what I see?
Oh, yes, of course. Can we say slime? Slime? Maybe?
Slime. Yeah. I like that word. This match isn't over. What is he doing?
Ring the bell. I've seen enough. Ring the bell.
Ring the bell?
I'll tell you what.
Uh-oh.
What is happening?
Gentlemen, you put on your best efforts. But TJ, last show that we had, I literally stood right there, gave you 60 seconds against Ryan Wilde, and look where that turned up. And Ethan, you're a great referee, but you're a better ref. You guys tried your best. I'll give you that. Great showing. But I'm not giving either of you a contract.
That's not fair in the slightest.
No, that's
what a
so
slime ball.
Yes.
Slime ball.
Angelo, get these two out of my ring.
his ring?
Hey, I told you what to do. I said, get in here.
Uh-oh. Angelo says no.
He did. He told him no.
He's refusing authority.
After week after week, I got to sit here while you use your executive director power to bully everyone in the back. For week after week, I got to sit here while you bully these great fans of XVW.
Oh, really?
And you know what, Bryce? I'm tired of it.
Oh my gosh. He speaks. Man.
You know what, Bryce? I have one question for you.
Uh-oh.
What are you going to do when a bunch of misfits push back?
I think Bryce might be a little overpowered at this point.
Fellas, hey, we can talk.
I don't think they want to talk.
They don't want to talk. They want that contract.
Oh, yeah.
They want their revenge.
There ain't no talking this out, Bryce. We're done talking.
Oh, Bryce is running.
Oh, that's it. You're going to try and punch me, huh? Real classy, boys. You know what? Fine. No, I'm not giving you that satisfaction. How about you want to talk? Meet me back there.
Turn out the way we thought it was going to.
But I think it was the best possible outcome. It shows that people are sick and tired of how Bryce Sear is running the show.
Come every welcome.
Nice so far.
When is he ever nice, though?
No, I'm just hoping he gets his discount at Burger King.
I'm just hoping that Travis wins this so Cameron doesn't have to be the King's lackey.
Oh, no doubt, right?
What? That's... You belong to me now, Cameron. You're going to be mine. I'm going to handle him. And you're going to belong to me.
King getting in Drake's face. Talk about a contact buzz.
He's coming in hot, and King doesn't have much he can do about it right now.
Ooh, drop kick.
Oh, just lay there and take it.
He better ease up on that.
Oh,
my God.
Man. That was a rough hit.
Ew.
Oh, I hope not.
I hope he has a pedicure first.
Oh, you hear the crowd. They've got Travis's back, but it's not looking the greatest.
Oh, speaking of backs, Logan just clobbers him in the back.
Still demanding those praises.
Travis fighting back with some slaps to the stomach, punches to the face. Oh, but Drake's not having that. Man. Travis needs to get up. Going for the cover. Kick out at two.
Oh, don't get too excited yet.
There's nothing to smile about. Why would you force that?
Not at this point, no.
Ooh. Ooh.
Oh, that was rough. He's going for it again.
And the pin. One, two. Ooh, and a kick out at like 2 3/4.
Nice.
You still belong to me! You still suck!
Oh, that was beautiful.
Wow.
You gotta hand it to Travis. He's always gonna come out and show out with all of his flips and everything.
Oh, he is angry now.
No, he took out Becky.
No.
Oh my gosh.
Oh, and this crowd is worried about her too. That don't look very good. We need a new ref.
What is he doing?
Bringing out the chair.
That's not necessary. Cameron interfering.
Cameron's not too happy about this.
Oh, you're kidding.
Oh, he did that. You've seen that.
Drop the chair. What are you doing? Oh, my gosh.
No.
He did not just do that. So, with him cheating like that, does that mean that Cameron is now his lackey for 30 days?
I think so, Erica.
Oh, oh no. Oh no.
This is not gonna go good.
Travis has no clue what's going on. He was out. He didn't see what happened.
And the turn of events are gonna unfold to be not very good.
Oh no. Drake forcing Cameron to come to him. But for what? I wouldn't do it. I would have walked out.
I demand a replay. Well, Erica, that chain looks mighty nice around Ganger's neck.
It really does. I bet you it's nice and heavy. It's just too bad that Nate couldn't come out on top to win that, but it's not that unfortunate.
That's very true, and you see referee Bucky holding it up right now for everybody to see. It looks beautiful.
Wait a minute.
I come through this town, and honestly, I thought I was on the video game Grand Theft Auto. This place is a dump. And I said, who would want to live here? And then I look at all of you, and I see exactly who would want to live here. A bunch of white trash losers. But I'm here on official business. I'm here to take your championship tonight.
Get the hammer before you see me like that King Kong in the crow.
Okay, I'm getting a little confused here, Erica.
I am always confused most of the time, but apparently King Kong Pete and Jeff Paul have now inserted themselves into this match.
So we got ourselves a four-way going on here.
There's going to be a lot going on and a lot to keep up with. Oh!
Well,
King Kong Pete with the cooking pan to Nate McLean's head. While Jeff Paul has Ganger in the corner.
Oh, King Kong Pete's not done yet. Okay, where's that going?
He's got his nanner stick. Giving him a couple spankings. And a clothesline from Ganger to Paul in the ring.
Ow! That kendo stick really looks like it hurts. Ooh! Nate McLean giving the favor back to King Kong Pete.
Ooh, shoulder tackle from Ganger to Paul.
Ganger's got the pit bull going strong tonight.
Choking Paul in the corner of the ring. Ooh, Nate throws Pete into the corner post. Nate McLean jabbing King Kong Pete with that kendo stick. Ooh! Leg drop from Paul to Ganger.
Ah, he's picking up that pan.
Paul so gingerly hits Pete on the head.
Ooh, two count, that's it. Ganger wasn't done yet.
Ganger's got a lot to lose, so he better not be ready to give up quite yet.
Oh, the kendo stick keeps coming out.
Uh-oh.
Nate McLean, he's got King Kong Pete where he thinks he wants him.
You think he's trying to get him to go to sleep? Oh, but Ganger's not having that. And Paul wasn't having that. Paul choking Ganger on the ropes with a kendo stick. McLean getting Pete in the corner and just giving him some low blows.
Oh!
Is that a hug?
No, I don't think so. Oh! That's a nice chop, though.
We love chops.
Are they ganging up on Nate McLean?
Ganger's not afraid of Tommy Foreman. He's putting the gorilla head on Nate. Oh, no.
I don't want to know where this stick is going.
Serving him a nana surprise. Uh-oh. Nate McLean throws Pete out while Paul has Ganger in the corner again.
Those are some big boots.
There's a lot of them.
What's Nate McLean's got some duct tape?
What does he plan to do? He should save that for when he does finally get the touch of a woman.
Yeah, he needs duct tape to get the touch of a woman?
Yeah, sadly. Okay.
Yeah, I getcha.
Ooh, chops from Paul to Ganger.
Oh, he missed that chop. Ganger giving it right back.
Showing him how it's done.
Oh, King Kong Pete stuck on the side of the ring.
Is that Chimera?
Oh, it is. Oh! Bucky only counted to the two. Chimera helping Nate McLean to the back, kind of viciously.
Paul's not too happy. He's ready for Gaynor. Get up. What does he have planned? Uh-oh. Oh! Went for the spear, but head first into a chair.
Gaynor hanging on. Good luck getting out of that grip.
He's got him now. Is that a good night?
Uh-oh, he doesn't look like he's awake.
He's out.
Oh,
that's it.
The bell.
Gaynor keeps his title.
And still, XVW Street Fight Team Champion.
Someone needs to cut Pete out. He's duct taped to the ring.
Man, no, it's not a dream. It's an XVW and they're gonna be thrilling you. They get hardcore, blood covering the floor. They take it out of the ring, they the wrestling kings. When it comes to a show, be ready for the bows. Cause they ain't slow, sit right in the front row. Cause